I've got some new ways that will take your graphic design process from what you're used to seeing up to something more advanced. Now, let me ask you this question. How do you choose colors for your graphic designs at the moment? Maybe you use something like Adobe Color or color scheme systems. Now, of course, that's completely fine, but I found something that's so awesome and so useful, it might actually completely blow your graphic design mind. This is Atmos app, and it's 100% free and 100% not a sponsor. So at the top here, we have the color generator, color wheel, shade generator, and playground. And remember, this is just the first thing I'm going to show you today. I have got lots of different tips coming in this video for your next graphic design project. So in Atmos, we can simply click generate to create color schemes, but this isn't really that useful. I always talk about creating designs and visual languages that target people, emotion, and desires. And here we can do that with color, simply by selecting an emotion or emotions. So for this color scheme, fun and playful will probably work well. Importantly, we can choose the industry sector of our design. So let's give fashion a try. Then when we click generate, we now have targeted results in terms of color. And by the way, we are looking at the two colors on the right, which right now is kind of limiting with just two. So if I want to add more colors to my scheme, all I do is click the plus icon right here. Now, running with the four color scheme approach, we can easily find a combination that's going to work for our design. However, we have a lot more to explore with this tool yet. And I'm not going to go into the color wheel because most of us know all about that already. But heading into the shade generator, you'll see how cool this thing gets. Now, to enter into the shade generator, just click add color here and then type in the hex color code or manually select a color. Our lightness settings are found right here on the right in this neat, cool panel. This will dictate how many colors are in your shade range. And once ready, click generate and it will give you shades or tints based on your starting color. Now, this thing is easy to use, and I repeat from earlier, it's completely free to use. So this setup should have my chosen color in the middle with lighter and darker colors either side, in theory. And yeah, that's close enough. But lastly, with this tool, we can export our shade scheme here, and there are a bunch of different options that we can use, which is nice. But yeah, it's a very well-rounded tool. It's really easy to use, and it just takes selecting colors and using colors to that next level. Next, I'm here on Google Trends, and we're going to be using it in conjunction with ChatGPT for graphic designs in a way that you've never seen before. So in Google Trends, head into the Explore option, and you can choose a country or a place, and that would depend on your client's project, of course. And we can also adjust the data time frame here. But first, we need to head over to ChatGPT. Now, let's say I'm designing a package design for an organic juice brand, and I want to find out some phrases or areas of social culture that are linked to organic juice. Now, if you follow this, what I'm going to show you, you will elevate your design process beyond the basics, way beyond the basics. So as you can see, we have health conscious, environmental awareness, and so on. These are typical things linked to people who drink organic juice. But what I really want to do is to grab one of these, let's say wellness culture, and then come back to Google Trends and paste it in. Now, this result is actually quite bad. And changing it to a smaller data sample didn't really help. So I'm going to head over to worldwide instead. Okay, so that's a nice set of data. And if we snap this to 1 year, yeah, we can see that the interest in the subject has been a bit all over the place. But if we change things up to, say, the last 5 years, we can see it's actually trending up in some way, fashion. What we are doing here is looking to see what is really trending at the moment. And in doing so, we'll be able to make design decisions that will appeal to more of a target audience. And by the way, this isn't a good idea for logo or brand design, but it works for pretty much everything else in graphic design. However, I'm going to show you the real secret when it comes to using Google Trends as a graphic designer. The best thing to do is to actually compare the areas of culture and subject within your chosen industry. That way you can see just how much weight one topic has above another. And when you know this, you can then take the topic to ChatGPT again. So here you can do things like ask for color palettes based around the more weighty topic, or what typography would best suit that subject, and even suggest concepts for a design based around that weighty subject. And that is, of course, in regard to your design, so package design, brochure, poster, whatever it is. Using ChatGPT with Google Trends like this just adds an extra layer of professional and advanced targeting. Now, this isn't something you're going to hear many graphic designers talk about, but of course, as you can see, it's hugely powerful and hugely useful. So next, we're jumping into Photoshop. Well, kind of. You'll see why I mean kind of in a minute. So those who use Photoshop quite often or a lot might be really fast when using the tools and the UI layout, but they might not be so fast in Illustrator. This can be annoying for those designers who want some quick vector graphics, as they have to move to AI, create it, save it, and then, you know, move it into Photoshop. But not anymore. So here's a raster shape that I've designed. First, on the layer panel, hold down Command or Control and then select it. Then press M and click the design with Control held down. You want to use the Make Work Path option and use a tolerance of 1, that's fine. You'll notice a path now exists around your design that looks a bit like a vector. Then press A and Control click again, and then create a vector mask. You'll know if you've done it correctly because your layers panel will look like this. Now, when it comes to exporting this as a vector EPS file, some people do run into issues and they can't do it. There are two reasons for this, and the first reason is because they might be using something else apart from 8-bit right here. You should be using 8-bit for this workflow. Secondly, the issue is that they come to save it and they use save as, and they can't find the EPS file option. If that applies to you, then simply come down to save as copy, and then you should have the EPS file format available to you. And that is, of course, a vector file format. And that's how you can make vector designs pretty easily in Photoshop without swapping between programs. And speaking of Adobe Illustrator and also vector graphics, I'm now going to show you an advanced workflow in Adobe Illustrator for you vector freaks out there like myself. So I have some text here, pretty standard stuff. If I come into the properties panel, we could do things you typically assume, like change the weight, the kerning, and so on. But let me come into Google and show you this search result. Free variable fonts. Now take note, there are Google fonts to that found here, but right now I'm interested in the font-esque ones. And there's some pretty interesting results if you look through these. But I am liking this one here, BD Lifeless. So let me install that and I'll be right back. With this font installed, we now have an icon in the properties panel that wasn't there before. This is the variable font menu. For this font in specific, we only have a weight slider, but that's still pretty cool nonetheless. We can change between weights in a fluid and intuitive way. But some variable fonts have more options than just weight. If we come up here and search for one of my favorites, that is Archivo, we can see that we now have width and weight options to play around with. But it can get more diverse than even that. This typeface here, Commissioner, gives access to flare, slant, weight, and also volume. Now, variable fonts are the way of the future, and they will likely kill off the old method for using typography. So be sure to check in the properties panel if the font you're using at the moment is variable or not. Also, be sure to drop a like on today's video if you did find something useful and you have learned something today. And also, if you want to keep learning, just click the video on screen. But until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.